Welcome, Dr. Jaya's Virtual School, LOIC Level 4. Learning Package, Academic Week 1, Social Concept, Natural Vegetation. India, Physical Environment. Beautiful flowers from India. Meaning of natural vegetation. Natural vegetation and wildlife exist only in the narrow zone of contact between the lithosphere, hydrosphere and atmosphere that we call biosphere. In the biosphere, living beings are interrelated and interdependent on each other for survival. This life supporting system is known as the ecosystem. This is the flora and fauna of India. Vegetation and wildlife are valuable resources. Plants provide us with timber, give shelter to animals, produce oxygen we breathe, protect soils so essential for growing crops, act as shelter belts, help in storage of underground water, give us fruits, nuts, lactose, turpentine oil, gum, medicinal plants and also the paper that is so essential for your studies. There are innumerable uses of plants and you can add some more. Wildlife includes animals, birds, insects as well as the aquatic life forms. They provide us milk, meat, hides and wool. Insects like bees provide us honey, help in pollination of flowers and have an important role to play as decomposers in the ecosystem. The birds feed on insects and act as decomposers as well. Vulture, due to its ability to feed on dead livestock, is a scavenger and considered a vital cleanser of the environment. So animals, big or small, all are integral to maintain balance in the ecosystem. India, natural vegetation, cold desert and hot desert. You have tropical moist deciduous, tropical wet evergreen and tropical semi-evergreen and tropical dry deciduous vegetation. You have tropical thermo-vegetation, alpine and subalpine, Himalayan dry temperate and Himalayan moist temperate, subtropical coniferous. Tropical rainforest. The tropical rainforest or evergreen forest of India supports a diversity of plant and animal species and its biotic system is constantly being stressed by various human activities. Rainforests are very dense, warm, wet forests. They are heavens for millions of plants and animals and are extremely important in the ecology of the earth. These plants are also very important to people in other ways. Many are used in new drugs that fight diseases and illness. They occupy about 7% of the Earth's land surface and have more than half of the world's plants and animals. They are found mostly near the equator. These forests are dense and multi-layered. The trees are evergreen as there is no period of drought. They are mostly tall and hardwood type. Leaves are broad and give out excess water through transpiration. Area. In India, evergreen forests are found in the western slopes of the Western Ghats in states such as Kerala and Karnataka. They are also found in hills of Jaintia and Kashi, parts of West Bengal and Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Climate. The tropical evergreen forests usually occur in areas receiving more than 2000 centimeters of rainfall and having a temperature of 15 to 30 degrees Celsius. Flora. The trees found in Indian tropical forests are rosewood, mahogany, and ebony. Bamboos and reeds are also common. Fauna. They provide shelter to elephants, gaur, and other large animals. Himalayan animals such as sahar, pine marten, and European otter live here. The other species found in this region are Nilgiri langur, Nilgiri brown mongoose, striped-necked mongoose, lion-tailed macaw, slender taurus, Malabar civet, and spring mouse. In north-eastern part, hoolock gibbon and golden langur are found. Bintrong, red pandas, slow lord, these are the characteristics of the park. Giant squirrels, civets, and bats also dwell in this tropical rainforest. The flowers we find in India are rose, marigold, sunflower, magnolia, dahlia, daffodil, lotus, jasmine, hibiscus, and chrysanthemum, daisy, and tulip. They all have Indian names too, especially in Hindi. Rose is called gulab, marigold is called gainda, sunflower is called surajmukhi, magnolia is called champa, dahlia is called dahlia, daffodil is called pilar nargis, lotus is called kamal, jasmine is called chameli, hibiscus is called gudhai, and chrysanthemum is called guldaudi, daisy is called gulbahar, and tulip is called nalini. Tropical deciduous forest. Deciduous forests have predominantly broadleaf trees. They shed their leaves for 6 to 8 weeks during the dry season, usually from March to May, to prevent the loss of moisture through evaporation. The area they occur on the wetter western side of the Deccan Plateau, the northeastern part of the Deccan Plateau, and the lower slopes of the Himalayas, on the Shivalik hills of Jammu in the west to West Bengal in the east. They cover parts of Chhattisgarh, Orissa, Bihar, Jharkhand, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Kerala, and Tamil Nadu. Here is a potential bird watching areas in India. We have central India, then we have in the Western Ghats, Ooty, Top Slip, Sedghat, Munnar, and Periyar. And we also have in Sikkim, Darjeeling, Lhasa, Eagle Nest, and Nameri and Namda, Kajiranga, in the runs of Kutch, Thar Desert, Jaipur, New Delhi, Corbelt, and Chambal. Climate. The tropical monsoon deciduous forests are found in areas receiving annual rainfall of 100 to 200 centimeters in India, with a distinct dry and rainy season and a small range of temperature. Flora. The principal trees of these forests are teak, sal, sandalwood, mahua, khar, mango, jackfruit, wattle and bamboo, simal, sisam, myrobalan, arjun, and the banyan tree. Fauna. Some important wildlife of these forests are Asiatic elephant, sambar, cheetah, wild buffaloes, tiger, and leopard. Uses of the forest. Timber, food, medicine, chemicals, tourism, habitat, research, recreation, education, and fuel wood. Uses of natural vegetation and wildlife. Many agriculture species are grown for single products and for specialized uses, but forest trees are often grown for more than just pulp are timber, and even those products have multiple end uses. People began life on this planet as forest dwellers. They were food gatherers and depended on the forest for all their needs, food, clothing and shelter. They gradually became food growers, clearing a small patch in the forest to grow food. Here is a picture of a tree, how it gives you first maintaining quantity of water, then maintaining quality of water, natural treatment of wastewater, maintaining nutrients in the soil and green lungs. Direct uses of forest, food. Plants are the basic producers which provide the human world with food to eat and survive. The food chain depends completely on these producers, which is the only living component that can produce its own food. Much of the human nutrition depends on land plants, either directly or indirectly. Human nutrition depends to large extent on cereals, especially maize, wheat and rice. Other staple crops include potato, cassava, legumes. Human food also includes vegetables, spices and certain fruits, nuts, herbs and edible flowers. Beverages produced from plants include coffee, tea, wine, beer and alcohol. Sugar is obtained mainly from sugar cane and sugar beet. Cooking oils and margarine come from maize, soya bean, rape seeds, sunflower and safflower, olive and others. Food additives include gum, arabic, guar gum, locust bean gum, starch and pectin. Livestock animals including cows, pigs, sheep and goats all are herbivores and feed primarily or entirely on cereal plants, particularly grasses. Here is the forest garden, a 7-level beneficial girls. The first is a canopy, that's a large fruit and nut tree. The second will be the low tree layers, dwarf fruit trees, shrub layers, currants and berries, herbivores, conifers, beets and herbs, rhizophora, root vegetables, soil surface, ground cover, strawberry, and then vertical layers, climbers and vines. Grazing animal husbandry. Animal husbandry involves the process of increasing the population of cattle animals so as to provide their milk, meat, wool, hides. This involves the grazing of these cattle in vegetation areas. This is now leading to overgrazing, which leads to soil erosion. But the vegetation is the main producer, which provides the animals to feed. Employment. Forests provide employment opportunities to rural and tribal folk and provides wood and to rural and tribal folk and provides food, wood and forest products like honey, herbs, fruits, berries and materials for domestic use. Other people of the urban areas are employed in the forest for lumbering and other vegetation products for industrial use. Here is a map of Indian cash crops. Indian cash crops are there in Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Orissa, West Bengal, Bihar, Uttar Pradesh, Haryana, Punjab and Jammu, and also some cash crops are there in Rajasthan. Fodder. Fodder from the forest forms an important source for cattle and other grazing animals in the hilly and the arid regions and during a drought. There are many varieties of grasses, trees and shrubs that are nutritious for the livestock. Care is taken to see that trees poisonous to cattle are not grown. Trees that produce a large crown above the reach of the cattle are preferred. Wildlife preservation. Forests are the natural habitat for wildlife. Wildlife have four basic requirements: food, cover, water and space. Different wildlife species require different stages of forest growth to meet these needs. Several aspects of your property determine how many species can live and thrive in your forest. Plant cover, harvest operations, water resources and topography. Your forest may have streams, swamps, rivers, ponds and areas that adjoin fields and pastures, roads and other openings. Even managing these edges of your forest is crucial to abundant population of some wildlife species. The relationship between vegetation management and wildlife species habitat is well established, hence forming a natural habitat for the fauna. Here is a map of Indian climatic zone, which does help in forestation. Shelter. In many parts of the world, wood is used for creating proper shelter against the elements. Items found in the wooded structure we call home are also made with wood, a plant product. Furniture, for example, is made up mainly of wood and cloth from the fibers of plants. Walls in homes may be decorated with wallpapers, and many paints are derived from plant extracts. India was the sugar producing state, and it's the oldest industry in India. Now here are some places where you have high sugar producing states and medium and low. For example, Maharashtra and Uttar Pradesh are the high sugar producing states. Gujarat, Andhra, Karnataka and Tamil Nadu are the medium producing states, and the rest of India is the low producing state. Wind breaks and shelter belts. Trees grown for wind breaks should be bushy and sturdy to withstand strong winds, both hot and cold. Along the Saurashtra coast in India, Casuarina has successfully been planted to check degradation due to salt-laden coastal winds. A species of Rosphosis is planted along the desert border in Haryana and Gujarat, has successfully halted the advance of the desert. Fencing. Fences created with trees and shrubs are preferred in developing countries as they are cheap to maintain yet give protection. Species that have thorns are prickly and have stiff branches and leaves that are not edible are preferred. These species should be fast growing, hardy and long lived. Indirect use. Industrial raw material. Forest supply materials required for various industrial purposes. Paper industries mainly depend on forests for its raw material. Forest supply other materials such as gums, resins, oil extracts, dyes, etc. Environment protection. Vegetation is the only natural factor which has the ability to gain control over almost all the environmental factors. Rainfall is a strong factor that is controlled by forests. Soil erosion. Natural vegetation acts as a natural barrier to reduce the wind velocity, thus preventing soil erosion. The root system holds the soil intact and protects it from erosion by running water. Medicines. Medicinal plants, herbs, species and herbal remedies are known to Ayurveda in India since long time. The leaves of tulsi plant, when eaten, prevent infections of the throat. Neem, another useful plant, is used for curing skin problems and for clearing the blood of impurities. Cinnachona provides artificial quinine, which is used in the treatment of malaria. In this manner, plants have a large number of uses from the ancient times till today. Fuel wood. Green plants, which lived on the earth very long ago, are the origin of the coal, oil and gas that humans use for heating and cooking purposes. Compression and heat have converted these plants into forest fuels. In Ireland, a common fuel is peat, which is formed by the same process as coal. The oldest form of fuel is wood, burned to create heat for warmth and for cooking, especially in India. Paper. Paper is a grass-like plant, was used more than 4,000 years ago in the first endeavor by Egyptians to make paper. It is from this plant that paper has derived its name. The Chinese around 1000 AD invented a method of manufacturing paper that is still in use today. The fibers from the plant are placed in water, reduced to but a pulp. After the water has been sieved off, the remaining pulp is pressed and then allowed to dry to yield a very thin sheet of paper. Almost any plant that is found to be high in cellulose is considered excellent for making the pulp which produces paper, the most common today being trees such as aspen and pine varieties. Rubber and gum. These are the daily products which we use in our life, which is also obtained from the natural vegetation. Rubber is a yellowish, amorphous, elastic material obtained from the milky sap or latex of various tropical plants, especially the rubber tree, and vulcanized, pigmented, finished and modified into products such as electric insulation, elastic bands and belts, tires and containers. Gum is a viscous substance that is exuded by certain plants and trees and dry into water soluble, non-crystalline, brittle solid, which is used as adhesives. Wood. It is the most important product obtained from the forest. Wood is used for fuel wood, construction of buildings and making musical instruments and decorating items. Chemical treatment of wood leads to the production of plastics, rayon, synthetic rubber, cellophane and many more such items. Wood can also be used to produce wood sugar, wood alcohol, useful chemicals and dyes. In India, 33% of total energy is provided by wood. Wildlife. Domestic animals are tamed and cared for by man. Wild animals roam free in forests and mountains. Both are useful to us. Animals keep the balance of oxygen and carbon dioxide in nature. They give carbon dioxide to plants that make oxygen and carbon dioxide in nature. They give carbon dioxide to plants that make food and release oxygen. They also provide us milk and other useful products and services. We get milk from cows, buffaloes and goats. Milk is rich in proteins and fats. It is called completed food because young babies live wholly on milk. Curd, cheese, butter, ghee and ice creams are made from milk. Some people eat flesh and eggs of animals, but current scientific researchers are against this. Flesh and eggs rot very soon and cause food poisoning and much communicable diseases from the animals and the environment. We get wool from the fleecy hair of sheep, yak, angora, rabbits, etc. Woolen clothes keep us warm in winter. Honey is sweet liquid. It is made of by honey bees. Honey bees also make wax. They use this wax to make their own home. Men use this wax to make candles, medicines. Dog watches our house, farms and animals. It is also a good companion. People breed cats, rabbits and pigeons for their beauty and grace. Parrot is a beautiful bird which can talk like humans. People have been using cattle dung as manure and fuel. But now, gobar gas is made from it and the remaining waste it is used as good manure. This manure helps us to maintain the fertility of the soil. Horses, donkeys, mules and camels carry loads and pull carts for us. Camels are ship of deserts. Bullocks are used to plow fields and to pull carts. Elephants are trained for shifting and carrying heavy logs in deep forests. Yaks carry loads on mountains. Some persons kill rabbits to get fur. Their skin with soft, delicate hair is called fur. Fur coats and fur caps are made from it. Similarly, silkworms and lac. Insects and oysters are killed for silk clothes. Lac bangles and pearl garlands. These are all cruel practices just for fun and decoration. Man is the most developed animal. Plants, animals and humans are all members of one big family. So we should not kill our fellow members. Welcome to Dr. Jaya's Virtual School. Like school, level 4. Learning Package, Academic Week 2, Concept Social. Come on friends, let us learn today how the continents are formed. Dear friends, are you able to see that earth? Yes, we'll be learning about those continents which were together and got separated. Here is the story of 7 continents and just see how they changed to 6 continents and there are 5 in early days and still earliest were only 4 continents. Then what is a continent? A continent is one of the several very large land masses on Earth. They are generally identified by convention rather than any strict criteria, with 7 regions commonly regarded as continents. The light of hope and having the continents. What are the continents then? They are from the largest in size to smallest are Asia, Africa, North America, South America, Antarctica, Europe and Australia. Plate tectonics is the geological process and study of the movement, collision and division of continents, earlier known as continental drift. What is continental drift? Alfred Wegener first proposes Continental Drift in his book published in 1915. He suggests that 200 million years ago, there existed one large supercontinent which he calls Pangaea. How did Pangaea look? This is the way it looked. Eurasia, North America, South America, Antarctica, Australia, Africa, and in the middle you find India. Conventionally, continents are understood to be large, continuous, discrete masses of land, ideally separated by expanses of water. Many of the seven most commonly recognized continents identified by convention are not discrete land masses separated by water. The criterion large leads to arbitrary classification. Greenland, with a surface area of 21,66,886 square kilometers, is considered the world's largest island, while Australia at 76,17,930 square kilometers is deemed to be a continent. Just see how the continents got drifted. Extent of continent. The narrowest meaning of continent is that of a continuous area of land or mainland with the coastline and any land boundaries forming the edge of the continent. From the perspective of geology or physical geography, continent may be extended beyond the confines of continuous dry land to include the shallow, submerged, adjacent area and the islands on the shelf, as they are structurally part of the continent. As a cultural construct, the concept of a continent may go beyond the continental shelf to include oceanic islands and continental fragments. In this way, Iceland is considered part of Europe and Madagascar part of Africa. Extrapolating the concept to its extreme, some geographers group the Australasian continental plate with other islands in the Pacific into one continent called Oceania. This allows the entire land surface of the Earth to be divided into continents or quasi-continents. Just see the mass of land getting divided. Today, seven continent theory holds good. Separation of continents. The ideal criteria that each continent be a discrete landmass is commonly disregarded in favor of more arbitrary historical conventions. Of the seven most commonly recognized continents, only Antarctica and Australia are completely separated from other continents. Several continents are defined not as absolutely distinct bodies, but as more or less discrete masses of land. Asia and Africa are joined by the isthmus of Suez, and North and South America by the isthmus of Panama. Both these isthmuses are very narrow in comparison with the bulk of the land masses they join, and both are transected by artificial canals, the Suez and the Panama canals, which effectively separate these land masses. This picture shows us how the land was getting drifted 550 million years ago, how it was, and then 200 million years ago, 136 million years ago, 65 million years ago, and the present state. The division of the land masses of Eurasia into the continents of Asia and Europe is an anomaly, as no sea separates them. The alternative view that Eurasia is a single continent results in a six-continent view of the world. This view is held in geology and geography. The separation of Eurasia into Europe and Asia is viewed by some as a residue of Eurocentrism. In physical, cultural and historical diversity, China and India are comparable to the entire European landmass, not to a single European country. A better, if still imperfect, analogy would compare France not to India as a whole, but to a single Indian state, such as Uttar Pradesh. However, for historical and cultural reasons, the view of Europe as a separate continent continues in several categorizations. Even with this argument, the seven continent theory holds good. North America and South America are treated as separate continents in the seven continent model. When continents are defined as discrete land masses embracing all the contiguous land of a body, then Asia, Europe and Africa form a single continent known by various names such as Afro-Eurasia. This produces a four-continent model consisting of Afro-Eurasia, America, Antarctica, and Australia. The land masses are only of the continents. Here is the fauna of different continents. When sea levels were lower during the Pleistocene Sea Ice Age, greater areas of continental shelf were exposed as dry land, forming land bridges. Three discrete continents, Afro-Eurasia, America, Antarctica and Australia, New Geneva. Just see how they got drifted. This shows you the continental drift. There are numerous ways of distinguishing the continent. The four continental theory, the five continental theory, six continental theory, and seven continental theory. Identify the drift. History of the concept. Early concepts of the old world continent. The first distinction between continents was made by the ancient Greek mariners who gave the names Europe and Asia to the lands on either side of the waterways of the Aegean Sea, the Dardanelles Strait, the Sea of Marmara, the Bosphorus Strait and the Black Sea. The names were first applied just to lands near the coast and only later extended to include the hinterland, but the division was only carried through to the end of navigable waterways, and beyond that point the Hellenic geographers never succeeded in laying their finger on any island and inland features in the physical landscape that could offer any convincing line for partitioning an individual an invisible Eurasia. Then later, plate tectonics theory was born. Plate is a rigid piece of lithosphere floating on a partially plastic substrate. Thus, the seven major plates are Pacific, North American, South American, African, Eurasian, Antarctic, and Indo-Australian. The types of plate boundaries. There is a divergent boundary, a convergent boundary, and transform boundaries. Geographers have predicted the future Pangaea too. what will be the world in the future. Here is a picture of the future land masses. You have the old equator coming down, and then you have the central part called Namibia, near Namibia, that is the Africa becomes the center part. On either side of Africa, you will find the other continents coming and joining, that is North America, South America, Antarctica, Australia, Asia and Europe. All this will become one big landmass. We don't know what that will be called. Welcome to Dr. Jaya's Virtual School. Like school level 4. Learning package, academic week 3, social concept, Asia. Just observe the global map projection where India and Asia are shown. Asia. The story behind the name Asia is, the word Asia originated from the ancient Greek word Aia, first attributed to Herodotus about 440 BC in reference to Anatolia, or for the purposes of the describing the Persian war to the Persian Empire in contrast to Greece and Egypt. Originally referred to the east bank of the Aegean Sea, an area known to the Hittites as Asuwa, could have originated from the Aegean root Asis, which means muddy and filthy. It is also derived from the borrowed Semitic root Asu, which means rising or light, which refers to the sunrise. Asia thus meaning eastern land. In Greek mythology, Asia or Aeshi was the name of a nymph or a titan goddess of Lydia. Ancient continent name Asuwa has been suggested as the origin for the name of the continent Asia. Today, Asia is the largest continent in the world. Asia is the world's largest continent and is traditionally defined as part of the land masses of Eurasia, with the western portion of Eurasia occupied by Europe. Asia occupies the eastern part of the Eurasian landmass and the adjacent islands, and is separated from Europe by the Ural Mountains. Located to the east of the Suez Canal, east of the Ural Mountains and south of the Caucasus Mountains and the Caspian and Black Sea. So, we can say that it is located to the east of the Suez Canal, east of the Ural Mountains and south of the Caucasus Mountains and the Caspian and Black Sea. Bounded on the east by the Pacific Ocean, on the south by the Indian Ocean and on the north by the Arctic Ocean. Is also bounded on the east by the Pacific Ocean. Asia is the biggest continent. It has 17,139,445 square miles. In population, it is the most populous continent, approximately more than 4 billion people, that is 60% of the world's current human population is in Asia. These are the flags of Asian countries. Asia's temperatures recorded. Asia was ruled by the Mongolian Empire. Asia's fauna, the animals of Asia. Here you see the birds of Asia. Asian elephant. The country grouping. The Asia has been grouped into 3 to 4 zones. Here you have the countries which are grouped in Southeast Asia or South Asia. The countries are Afghanistan, Nepal, India, Pakistan, Bhutan, Bangladesh, Maldives, Sri Lanka, Malaysia, Singapore, Myanmar, Thailand, Brunei, Indonesia, Vietnam, Cambodia and Philippines. The West Asia, Iraq, Iran, Lebanon, Yemen, UAE, Israel, Jordan, Kuwait, Kingdom of Bahrain and State of Qatar. All these are West Asia. Central Asia, Kazakhstan, Mongolia, Korea, Kyrgyzstan, Tajikistan, China, Korea and Turkmenistan. All the 50 countries of Asia were marching together as continent here. Economy and currencies. Asia has the second largest nominal GDP of all continents after Europe, but the largest when measured in PPP. The largest economies in Asia are China, Japan, India, South Korea and Indonesia. Speaking of currency, there are different kinds of currencies used across Asia. Here are the different countries of Asia. Asian countries and their currency. Afghanistan uses Afghani, Armenia, Dram, Azerbaijan, Manat, Bahrain, Bahraini Dinar, Bangladesh, Taka, Bhutan, Nugultrun, Brunei, Brunei Dollar, China, Yuan, Cyprus, Cypriot Pound, Cambodia, Rail, East Timor, US Dollar, India, Indian Rupee, Indonesia, Rupiah, Iran, Rial, Iraq, Iraqi Dinar, Israel, Shekel, Japan, Yen, Jordan, Jordan Dinar, Kazakhstan, Tenge, Korea, Won, Korea South, Won, Kuwait, Kuwaiti Dinar, Kyrgyzstan, Kyrgyzstani Som, Laos, Kip, Lebanon, Lebanese Pound, Malaysia, Malaysian, Ringgit, Maldives, Rafia, Mongolia, Turkey, Myanmar, Kuwait, Nepal, Nepalese Rupee, Onam, Oman, Rial, Omani, Pakistan, Pakistani Rupee, Philippines, Pepso, Qatar, Qatari, Rial. Here is the country and capital of Asia. Afghanistan, Kabul is the capital. Armenia, Yerevan is the capital. Baku is the capital of Azerbaijan. Almanha, Bahrain. Dhaka, Bangladesh. Thimphu, Bhutan. Bandar Seri, Brunei. Beijing, China. Nicosia, Cyprus. Cambodia, Phnom Penh. Delhi, East Timor. New Delhi for India. Jakarta, Indonesia, Tehran, Iran, Baghdad, Iraq, and Tel Aviv, Israel. Tokyo is the capital of Japan, Amman, Jordan, Akmola, Kazakhstan, Pyongyang, Korea, Seoul, South Korea, Kuwait City, Kuwait, Bishkek, Kyrgyzstan, Vietnam, Laos, Beirut, Lebanon, Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia, Male, Maldives, Ulaanbaatar, Mongolia, Yangon, Myanmar, Kathmandu, Nepal, Muscat, Oman, Islamabad, Pakistan, Manila, Philippines, and Doha, Qatar. Resources of Asia. Each country has their own resources, natural gas resources, coal and hydro, crude oil, and they all are also rich in the many of the natural gases. Here are the Asian countries' flags. You can find different countries. Of 50 countries have 50 different kinds of flags, but most of the flags have real good colors in them, especially red, then yellow, blue, green are very prominent. Languages. Asia is a home to several language families and many language isolates. Most Asian countries have more than one language that is natively spoken. 600 languages are spoken in Indonesia, more than 800 languages spoken in India, more than 100 are spoken in the Philippines. China has many languages and dialects in the various provinces. Colonization. Colonization in Asia traces its roots back to the late 15th century with a series of voyages that sought a sea passage to India in the hope of establishing direct trade between Europe and Asia in spices. Before 15th century, European economies were largely self-sufficient, only supplemented by minor trade with Asia and Africa. Within the next century, however, European and Asian economies were slowly becoming integrated through the rise of new global trade routes. Culture of Asia. Asian art, music, cuisine, and literature are important parts of Asian culture. Eastern philosophy and religion also play a major role in Asian culture, with Hinduism, Taoism, Confucianism, Buddhism, Christianity and Islam all represented. One of the most complex parts of Asian culture is the relationship between traditional cultures and the Western world. This is a cultural Asia. Asia is rich in the culture. May it be music or dance or arts and crafts. So all the liberal arts are there in nook and corner of Asia. Asia has a rich heritage of its cuisine. They are very good hosts and they have very good kitchen. They have the taste of the tongue. Welcome to Dr. Jaya's Virtual School. Like school level 4. Academic week 4, History of Asia. Asia has exotic locations, rich history and magical mythology. The history of Asia can be seen as the collective history of several distinct peripheral coastal regions such as East Asia, Southeast Asia and the Middle East, linked by the interior mass of the Eurasian steppe. The coastal periphery was the home to some of the world's earliest known civilizations, with each of the three regions developing early civilizations around fertile river valleys. These valleys were fertile because the soil there was rich and could bear lots of root crops. The civilizations in Mesopotamia, the Indus Valley and the China shared many similarities and likely exchanged technologies and ideas such as mathematics and the wheel. Other notions such as that of writing likely developed individually in each area. Cities, states and then empires developed in these lowlands. The steppe region had long been inhabited by mounted nomads, and from the central steppes they could reach all areas of the Asian continent. The northern part of the continent, covering much of the Siberia, was also inaccessible to the steppe nomads due to the dense forests and the tundra. These areas in Siberia were very sparsely populated. The center and periphery were kept separate by mountains and deserts. The Caucasus, Himalaya, Karakum Desert and Gobi Desert formed barriers from the steppe horsemen could only cross with difficulty, while technologically and culturally the city dwellers were more advanced. They could do little militarily to defend against the mounted hordes of the steppe. However, the lowlands did not have enough open grassland to support a large horse-bound force. Thus, the nomads who conquered states in the Middle East were soon forced to adapt to the local societies. BC to 4500 BC. A temple area in southeastern Turkey at Göbekli Tepe, dated to 10,000 BC, has been seen as the beginning of the Neolithic One culture. This site was developed by nomadic hunter-gatherers since there is no permanent housing in the vicinity. This temple site is the oldest known man-made place of worship. By 8500 to 8000 BC, farming communities began to spread to Anatolia, North Africa and North Mesopotamia. A report by the archaeologist the prehistoric Bifendi site near Zhejiang in Hebei province, China, contains relics of a culture contemporaneous with the Chizan and Xinglonghua cultures of about 7000 to 8000 BC. Neolithic cultures east of the Taihang Mountains, filling in an archaeological gap between the two northern Chinese cultures. Around 5500 BCE, the Halafian culture appeared in the Levant, Lebanon, Palestine, Syria, Anatolia, and northern Mesopotamia based upon dry land agriculture. In southern Mesopotamia were the alluvial plains of Sumer and Elam. Since there was little rainfall, irrigation systems were necessary. The Upayad culture flourished from 5500 BCE. Bronze Age, 4500 BC to 500 BC. The Chalcolithic period began about 4500 BCE, then the Bronze Age began about 3500 BCE, replacing the Neolithic culture. The Indus Valley civilization was a Bronze Age civilization, which was centered mostly in the western part of the Indian subcontinent, considered as early form of Hinduism performed during this civilization. China and Vietnam were also centers of metalworking. Dating back to the Neolithic age, the first bronze drums called the Dong Son drum have been uncovered in and around the Red River Delta regions of Vietnam and southern China. These relate to the prehistoric Dong Son culture of Vietnam, Songda bronze drum surface, Dong Son culture, Vietnam. In Bangcheong, Thailand, bronze artifacts have been discovered dating to 2100 BC. Burma bronze tools have been excavated along with ceramics and stone artifacts. Dating is still currently broad. Iron Age, 5500 500 BC to 600. The Archimedes dynasty of the Persian Empire, founded by Cyrus the Great, ruled an area from Greece and Turkey to the Indus River and Central Asia during the 6th to 4th centuries BC. Alexander the Great conquered this empire in the 4th century BC. The Roman Empire would later control parts of Western Asia. The Seleucid, Parthian, and other dynasties of Persia dominated Western Asia for centuries. Foundation of the Maurya Empire, which was geographically extensive and powerful empire in ancient India, ruled by the Mauryan dynasty from 321 to 185 BC. It was one of the world's largest empires in its time. At its greatest extent, the empire stretched to the north along the natural boundaries of the Himalayas and to the east, stretching into what is now Assam. To the west, it probably reached beyond modern Pakistan, annexing Balochistan and much of what is now Afghanistan, including the modern Herat and Kandahar provinces. India was united for the first time in the Mauryan Empire. The Gupta Empire was an ancient Indian empire which existed approximately from 320 to 550 CE and covered much of the Indian subcontinent. Founded by Maharaja Sri Gupta, the dynasty was the model of a classical civilization. Maurya and Gupta empires are called as the Golden Age of India and were marked by extensive inventions and discoveries in science, technology, art, religion, and philosophy that crystallized the elements of what is generally known as Indian culture. The religions of Hinduism and Buddhism, which began in Indian subcontinent, were an important influence on Southeast and Southwest Asia. The Qin dynasty was the first ruling dynasty of Imperial China, lasting from 221 to 206 BC. The Han dynasty was the second imperial dynasty of China, preceded by the Qin dynasty and succeeded by the Three Kingdoms. Spanning over four centuries, the period of Han dynasty is considered a golden age in Chinese history. To this day, China's majority ethnic group refers to itself as the Han people. Many ancient civilizations were influenced by the Silk Road, which connected China, India, the Middle East, and Europe. Middle Ages. The Islamic Caliphate and other Islamic states took over the Middle East, Caucasus, and Central Asia during the Muslim conquests of the 7th century and later expanded into the Indian subcontinent and Malaya Archipelago. The Mongol Empire conquered a large part of Asia in the 13th century, an area extending from China to Europe. Marco Polo was not the first Westerner to travel to the Orient and return with amazing stories of this different culture, but his accounts published in the late 13th century and early 14th centuries were the first to be widely read throughout the Europe. Chola dynasty of South India annexed most of Southeast Asia during 10th and 11th century. The Muslim conquest in the Indian subcontinent mainly took place from the 12th century onward, though earlier Muslim conquests made limited inroads into the region, beginning during the period of the ascendancy of the Rajput kingdoms in North India, although Sindh and Multan were captured in 8th century. Gunpowder was widely used as early as the 11th century and they were using movable type printing 500 years before Gutenberg created his press. Buddhism, Taoism, Confucianism were the dominant philosophy of the Far East during the Middle Ages. Middle Asia was the kingdom of the Khans. Never before had any person controlled as much land as Genghis Khan. He built his power unifying separate Mongol tribes before expanding his kingdom south and west. He and his grandson Kublai Khan controlled lands in China, Burma, Central Asia, Russia, Iran, the Middle East and Eastern Europe. Estimates are that the Mongol armies reduced the population of China by nearly a third. Genghis Khan was a pagan who tolerated nearly every religion, and their culture often suffered the harshest treatment from Mongol armies. The Khan armies pushed as far as west as Jerusalem before being defeated in 1260. The Middle Ages were an unsurpassed era for Chinese ceramics and paintings. Medieval architectural masterpieces, the Great South Gate in Todaiji, Japan, and Tianning Temple in Peking, China, are some of the surviving constructs from this era. The Black Death, which would later ravage Western Europe, had its beginning in Asia, where it wiped out the large populations in China in 1331. China flourished again late in the medieval era during the famed Ming Dynasty. In Japan, these later Middle Age centuries saw a return to the traditional Shinto faith and the continuing popularity of Zen Buddhism. Modern period, 1500 to present. The Russian Empire began to expand into Asia from the 17th century, eventually taking control of the Siberia and most of Central Asia by the end of 19th century. The Ottoman Empire controlled Anatolia, the Middle East, North Africa and the Balkans from the 16th century onwards. In the 17th century, the Manchu conquered China and established the Qing dynasty, although this was in decline by the 19th century and had been overthrown in 1912. In the 16th century, the Mughal Empire controlled much of India and initiated second golden age for India. China was largest economy in the world for much of the time, followed by India till the 18th century. The riches of India, China and Ottoman blockading the route led to discovery age in Europe, which led to discovery of America, sea route to India. The European powers had control of other parts of Asia by the 1900, such as British India, French Indochina, Spanish East Indies, and Portuguese Macau and Goa. The great game between Russia and Britain was the struggle for power in the Central Asian region in the 19th century. The Trans-Siberian Railway crossing Asia by train was complete by 1916. Parts of Asia remained free from European control, although not influenced, such as Persia, Thailand and most of India. In the 12th century, Imperial Japan expanded into China and Southeast Asia during the Second World War. After the war, many Asian countries became independent from European powers. During the Cold War, the northern parts of Asia were communist-controlled with the Soviet Union and People's Republic of China, while Western allies formed pacts such as CENTO and SEATO. Conflicts such as Korean War, Vietnam War and Soviet invasion of Afghanistan were fought between communists and anti-communists. In the decades after the Second World War, a massive restructuring plan drew Japan to become the world's second largest economy, a phenomenon known as the Japanese post-war economic miracle. The Arab-Israel conflict has dominated much of the recent history of the Middle East. After the Soviet Union's collapse in 1991, there were many new independent nations in Central Asia. Today, China, India, South Korea, Japan and Russia play important roles in world economies and politics. China today is the second largest economy of the world and fastest growing economy. India is the second fastest growing economy with second largest population after China. Historical maps of Asia. Historical monuments of Asia. Welcome to Dr. Jaya's Virtual School. Like School Level 4. Academic Week 5, Concept Social. Continent Africa. Geographical aspects of Africa. There are 54 countries on the African continent, including the disputed territory of Western Sahara and the islands. The island nations are Cape Verde, Sao Tome and Principe, Madagascar, the Comoros, the Seychelles and Mauritius. Each is an independent nation. Africa is the world's second largest and second most populous continent. At about 30.2 million kilometers, including adjacent islands, it covers 6% of the Earth's total surface area and 20.4% of the total land area. With 1 billion people, it accounts for about 15% of the world's human population. The continent is surrounded by the Mediterranean Sea to the north, both the Suez Canal and the Red Sea along the Sinai Peninsula to the northeast, the Indian Ocean to the southeast, and the Atlantic Ocean to the west. Africa, particularly Central East Africa, is widely accepted as the origin of humans. Africa straddles the equator and encompasses numerous climate areas. It is the only continent to stretch from the northern temperate to southern temperate zones. Afri was a Latin name used to refer to the Carthaginians who dwelt in North Africa in modern day Tunisia. Africa is the largest of the three great southward projections from the largest landmass of the earth. Separated from Europe by the Mediterranean Sea, it is joined to Asia at its northeast extremity by the Isthmus of Suez. From the most northerly point, Ras Ben Saka in Tunisia, to the most southerly point, Cape Agulhas in South Africa, is a distance of approximately 8,000 kilometers from Cape Verde, the westernmost point, to Ras Hafun in Somalia. The most easterly projection is a distance of approximately 7,400 kilometers. The coastline is 26,000 kilometers long. Africa's largest country is Algeria, and its smallest country is the Seychelles, an archipelago of the East Coast. The smallest nation on the continental mainland is the Gambia. Geologically, Africa includes the Arabian Peninsula, the Zagros Mountains of Iran, and the Anatolian Plateau of the Turkey mark where the African plate collided with Eurasia. The Afrotropic Ecozone and the Sahara Arabian Desert to its north unite the region biogeographically, and the Afroasiatic language family unites the north linguistically. Climate of Africa. The climate of Africa ranges from tropical to subarctic on its highest peaks. Its northern half is primarily desert or arid, while its central and southern areas contain both savanna plains and very dense jungle regions. In between, there is a convergence where vegetation patterns such as Sahel and steppe dominate. Africa is the hottest continent on earth. Dry lands and deserts comprise 60% of the entire land surface. The record of the highest temperature recorded was set in Libya in 1922. That was 58 degrees Celsius. African fauna. Africa boasts perhaps the world's largest combination of density and range of freedom of wild animal populations and diversity. With wild populations of large carnivores such as lions, hyenas and cheetahs, and herbivores such as buffalo, elephants, camels and giraffes ranging freely on primarily open non-private plains. It is also home to a variety of jungle animals, including snakes and primates, and aquatic life such as crocodiles and amphibians. In addition, Africa has the largest number of megafauna species, as it was least affected by the extinction of the Pleistocene megafauna. Flora of Africa. Africa's flora, vegetation, is tropical or subtropical. The flora in southern Africa has been most studied. The flora of central and northern Africa is less less known. Where more moisture is available, grasslands predominate, and as rainfall increases, grasslands gradually become tropical savanna. Tropical forests make up a much smaller area of Africa than the other two biomes. They are most abundant in the portions of Central Africa not dominated by the grassland or tropical savanna biome and are not far from the coastal Central West Africa. Ecology. Deforestation is affecting Africa at twice the world's rate. Since the arrival of humans 2000 years ago, Madagascar has lost more than 90% of its original forest. About 65% of Africa's agriculture land suffers from soil degradation. Crops. Cashew nuts in Geneva, bisou and cocoa beans in Ivory Coast as number one crops of Africa. Different kinds of vegetables are available in Africa. Amaranth, cabbage, cassava, collard greens, African eggplant, groundnut, huckleberry, kale, kettle, mustard greens, okra, palava sauce greens, hot peppers, purslane, African spinach, sweet potatoes, tomatoes, hardy yam and yard long beans. All these are available in Africa. Industry of Africa. Ghana had several products of industry including gold, salt, slaves, honey, jewelry, tools, metal and leather goods are rare birds, livestock, horses and special cloth called chiguguya. Gold and salt were mined and were the most sought after items. The mines were scattered to the south. In the city of Kumbi, the market people traded and sold cattle, honey, dates, ivory, cloth and ebony. In other shops at the market, local farmers sold their produce and craft people sold their wares. Most traders were Muslims. Decolonization of Africa was fraught with instability aggravated by Cold War conflict. Since mid-20th century, the Cold War and increased corruption and disposition have also contributed to Africa's poor economy. Much of Africa has stagnated and even regressed in terms of foreign trade, investment, per capita income and other economic growth measures. Poverty has had widespread effects including low life expectancy, violence and instability, which in turn have perpetuated the continent's growth problems. There are various sectors which are still doing good, sectors of agriculture, mining and drilling, manufacturing, investment and banking, communication and information technology. Biodiversity. Africa has over 3,000 protected areas with 198 marine protected areas, 50 biosphere reserves and 80 wetland reserves. Significant habitat destruction, increases in human population and poaching are reducing Africa's biological diversity. Human encroachment, civil unrest and the introduction of non-native species threatens biodiversity in Africa. This has been exacerbated by administrative problems, inadequate personnel and funding problems. The African Union. The African Union, which is called AU, is a 54 member federation consisting of all of Africa's states except Morocco. African countries, capitals and currency. Flags of African countries. Here are some of the African countries, flags, emblem, flowers and national animals. For example, Algeria, Angola, Botswana, Congo. Here you find the national emblems and flags of Egypt, Ethiopia, Ghana, Kenya, Libya, and Mauritius. Here you find the national emblems, flags and animals and flowers of Nigeria, South Africa and Tunisia. Welcome to Dr. Jaya's Virtual School. Like school, level 4. Academic week 6. Social concept, history of Africa. History of Africa. The races of Africa. The two main races inhabiting Africa in early times were the Berbers and the Mediterranean coastal lands and the Negroes of Africa. Historical time, that is when history is known with reasonable accuracy and some detail, started on widely different dates in the different regions of Africa, very roughly as follows. Egypt, about 3000 BC, Nush, about 1000 BC, Berber North Africa, about 1000 BC, Ethiopia, about AD, Western and Central Sudan, about AD 300, East Africa, about AD 700, the forest land south of the Western Sudan, about AD 1000. The Kushites, Meroe, Nubia. During the time of ancient Egypt's glory, during the 3rd and 2nd millennia BC, the influence of Egyptian civilization was strong in the land to the south. The eastern or Egyptian Sudan, often called Nubia and known to the Egyptians as Kush. The northern Nubians, darker skinned than the Egyptians, may have originally come from Asia. Those further south were Negroes. Egypt traded with, fought with and to some extent ruled over these people. North Africa in this history refers to what is now Morocco, Algeria, Tunisia and Libya. In Roman times, Mauritania, the land of the Maori or Moors, coincided roughly with modern Morocco. It is not to be confused with present-day Mauritania, which is further south, and the Roman name for part of what is now Tunisia and Algeria was Numida. Western Libya is called Tripolitania and Eastern Libya, Cyrenaica. North Africa, the Arabs. After the birth of Islam, early in the 7th century, the armies of the Semitic Arabs quickly conquered the whole of the Middle East, including Egypt, in 642. Later in the century, they went on from Egypt to the rest of North America, Africa, converting the Berbers as they went. By the end of the century, the Arab Empire had reached Morocco. The conversion was generally peaceful, the Berbers readily accepting Islam. About the only section of the population not converted were Jewish communities, and which were tolerated and treated well by the Arabs. The early kingdoms of the Western and Central Sudan. In early times, the peoples of the Western and Central Sudan were subject to many outside influences from the Egyptians, the Kushites and the Carthaginians, but mainly from the Berbers of the North African coastland. The links were the trade routes across the Sahara. Eastern and Central Africa, the Swahili. Along the east coast of Africa, an Indian Ocean trade conducted by Bantu-speaking peoples existed about 2000 years ago, and it received a great impetus from the Arabs after the rise of Islam in the 7th century. The Bantu-speaking Africans were called Swahili by the visiting Arabs, and the name remained attached to them and to their descendants of mixed Bantu Arab stock, and to their language, now the common language of East Africa. The West African Forest Kingdoms. In the thick forest belt south of the Western Sudan, grasslands movement was difficult except along the rivers, and the Negro tribes here in early times tended to remain small and scattered. The forest also protected them from the Sudanese empires to the north, whose military strength was based on their cavalry. The first known organized forest kingdoms were formed in about the 11th century AD by the Yoruba and the Edo people of Western Nigeria. North Africa from the 15th to 19th century. The 15th and 16th centuries in North Africa were a period of struggles between dynasties, insertions, raids and near anarchy. During this period, too, the Spaniards and Portuguese obtained a foothold in the ports of the Mediterranean coast. In 1415, the Portuguese captured Ceuta in Morocco, and the Spaniards took Oran in Algeria in 1409 and Melilla in Morocco in 1496. In 1578, however, a Portuguese crusade against the Moors in Morocco ended in disaster, in which the King of Portugal and the flower of the Portuguese nobility were killed. Portuguese exploration and colonization. Soon after the capture of Ceuta in 1415, the Portuguese, under an organization set up by Prince Henry, became the pioneers in European exploration to the western coast of Africa and the search for a sea route round Africa to the east. The trade route to the east through the Mediterranean and overland to the Red Sea and Indian Sea had for long been dominated by the Arabs and was also subject to interference by the Barbary pirates of the Mediterranean. The slave trade. The European colonists in America soon found the need for imported labor to work on the sugar plantations and in the mines, and later on the tobacco and cotton plantations. The Spaniards started using Negro slave labor in their West Indian colonies early in the 16th century, and the Portuguese in the middle of the century started sending slaves from Africa to Brazil. Other European nations soon joined in this lucrative trade, and the slave trade became big business. Africa in the early years of the 19th century. In the early part of the 19th century, the political situation in the different countries and regions of Africa was one of varying degrees of independence, and the social organization still varied from the kingdom to the tribe. European exploration, 1770 to 1870. Exploration of the interior of Africa by Europeans in search of geographical and other knowledge of the continent and not start until late in the 18th century. Previous expeditions for any distance into the interior, mainly by the Portuguese in the south, had been basically in search of trade or of slaves for the slave trade. French and British activities in Africa from the 1820s to 1880s. In the 1820s, the main European colonies in Africa were Portuguese Mozambique and Angola in the south, the French settlement in coastal Senegal, and the British possessions in addition to South Africa in Sierra Leone, the Gold Coast, and Gambia. The scramble for Africa. Until the 1870s, only Portugal, Britain, and France of the European nations had made any substantial colonization in Africa, and the French and British advances had been rather spasmodic, their colonial policies varying with the government or regime in power and with the enterprise of its representatives in Africa. The colonial period lasted for different lengths of time in the different colonies, ending with most African states obtaining independence in the 1950s and 1960s. The peak of the colonial era was roughly the first half of the 20th century, a period which included the two world wars. The Africans become independent. After the Second World War, nationalist movements in Africa quickly gained momentum. This was largely due to the war itself and its effects. Many thousands of Africans had fought in the Allied armies, expanding their outlook and their knowledge of international affairs, and the war had been, to some extent, an anti-racist war against the racist governments of the Axis powers. And many more Africans had by now received the beginnings of the modern education and began to take an interest in political matters. In many parts of Africa, outstanding leaders arose, such men as Kwame Nkrumah of the Gold Coast, Jomo Kenyatta of Kenya, Julius Nyerere of Tanzania, Sikoyu Tore of French Geneva, Herbert Boyingi of Ivory Coast. After independence, the newly independent African nations faced many problems, particularly those countries, the great majority, with no recent experience of being a national state. One awkward problem was that the boundaries of the new state often bore little or no relation to racial or tribal divisions. Traditional dances of Africa. Monuments 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 of Africa. African festivals. African cuisine. African jewelry. African traditional furniture. African masks.